We live in a world today where unfortunately a lot of communication is taking place with 140 characters, and probably it's best to refrain from communicating with 140 characters on topics that are so important.
Unusually blunt criticism from Senate Foreign Relations Chairman Bob Corker about the president's tweet storm against the mayor of London after the latest terror attack in his city. Joining me now is Republican Congressman Chris Collins of New York, a close advisor to President Trump during the campaign and, of course, since the election. Congressman, thank you for being with us today. Good to see you.
It's good to be with you, Andrea.
I want to know, do you agree with Senator Corker that
for the president... Oh, I couldn't disagree more.
Okay.
Yeah,
why?
I couldn't disagree more, Andrea. You know, I'm probably ground zero in Western New York, my eight counties of Trump territory. And I can tell you, my constituents like to hear unfiltered, honest conversation from President Trump. He does it through tweeting. His supporters absolutely love that he does that. He's speaking directly to them. He's going around the news media. And so in this unfiltered way of communicating today, he's getting a message across to his strong supporters. And so I fully endorse what he's doing. I think those that don't like it just need to accept that that is President Trump.
But let me ask you about the effectiveness, whether he's hurting his own message, his own presidency, his effectiveness on the Hill. Because if you look back, since he first tweeted about President Obama surveilling him, which was not the fact, and they had to walk that back. There are so many issues. Now the mayor of London is talking about withdrawing the state visit invitation because he clearly took the mayor of London out of context, misquoting him, misrepresenting what he had said to his people. And a lot of people are questioning the lack of sensitivity to attack the mayor of a city that has just come under attack.
Well, we have to go back, Andrea, to Mayor Khan and some things he said about terrorism in other parts of the world, where he effectively said, you know, we just have to get over it. That's part of life. That was a month or so ago. So Mayor Khan has not exactly been, forthcoming here recently about some of his own interactions.
We're talking about in the aftermath of a terror attack on his city,
sure.
Where he was saying, people do not be worried. We're flooding the area with extra police, so that you should not be alarmed by that. That was the context, but that was not what the president represented. And
this is our closest ally. Yes, but Mayor Khan was poking at President Trump well before that, and we all know that President Trump, if somebody takes a swing at him, he's going to swing back. And while I may not have been someone that would have tweeted what President Trump did, you know, putting some of that in context, was his opinion, and I would think it would be very small of Mayor Khan were he to withdraw a state visit. But this is clearly a person who doesn't like Donald Trump, has pretty much publicly stated that. He doesn't believe in his principles. So, President Trump is going to move on from this. He's going to keep America safe. He's working on diligently securing our borders. And he is taking to task some of those, even some of our sanctuary city mayors here, who don't have America's safety forefront in their head. And there are those liberals, and certainly Mayor Khan would be one of them, who would be the first to endorse the concept of sanctuary cities and just let anybody in. So that's a very different philosophy than our president that's working
let me bring it back to
keep us safe.
Let me bring it back to the current situation. There's reporting today in the New York Times that the president is getting concerned or upset or impatient with his attorney general, actually since the recusal. Have you heard of any dissatisfaction of the president's against the attorney general, Jeff Sessions?
No. And Andrea, think back to the election. Attorney General Jeff Sessions was at Donald Trump's side from the very earliest days of 2016. So, we're going on a year and a half. He's one of his most trusted
advisors. Which is why this would be so extraordinary if the president is, in fact, impatient because of his recusing himself, something the president very openly criticized at the time, recusing himself from the Russia investigation. So I'm just wondering whether there is a strain on that relationship, as far as you know.
I don't believe that there is at all. I agree that Attorney General Jeff Sessions was very careful to say, I'm going to take any and all potential criticism off the table. He's got a pretty good staff. He's got a good staff underneath him. And I for one, would not think that there's any issues whatsoever with our president and our attorney general. They are very close friends.
Now, when it comes to Twitter and the way the president has tweeted and offended allies, Angela Merkel and others, George Conway tweeted that the president was hurting himself. This is Kellyanne Conway's husband and a well-known Republican lawyer who was until recently under consideration for a Justice Department post, tweeting that he was actually, the president was hurting his own case in the Supreme Court on the travel ban by tweeting. And then you've got the Wall Street Journal today in its editorial saying that in 140-character increments, Mr. Trump diminished his own standing by causing a minor international incident, demonstrated that the loyalty he demands of the people who work for him is not reciprocal, set back his policy goals, wasted time that he could have devoted to health care, tax reform, or infrastructure week. Mark it all down as further evidence the most effective opponent of the Trump presidency is Donald J. Trump. That is the Wall Street Journal editorial page.
Oh, I hear you. I can just say I could respectfully and do respectfully disagree. Again, as somebody who represents, ground zero of Trump territory in the Northeast, he is speaking to his supporters and he is messaging to the United States his priorities, whether it's on infrastructure, tax reform, or keeping our country safe. I don't think there's any misunderstanding where President Trump's priorities are. He's got, the best cabinet ever assembled in the history of the United States. And those individuals, even though they are understaffed right now, are working overtime to implement a policy that will bring economic growth and jobs back in this country, whether it's less regulations or just understanding states' rights in the 10th Amendment. So, again, as one of his earliest supporters or his earliest one, I couldn't be more pleased about, what Donald Trump, the president, is doing, where he's going. And those of us on Capitol Hill, we just need to do our jobs. And I'd hate to think anyone would use as an excuse, whether it's health care, tax reform, or infrastructure, that it has anything to do with President Trump tweeting. I mean, that would be a pretty lame excuse.
Thank you very much, Congressman Collins, Chris Collins.
Good to be with you, Andrea.
Good, you too, sir. And coming up, more on the breaking news out of Paris, where a man attacked a police officer with a hammer. He also had knives in his backpack outside of Notre Dame. It's the calm after the storm right now. You can actually see a small rainbow at the cathedral right now. A beautiful shot from Paris. A live report next, right here on Andrea Mitchell Reports.